So, fur has been flying inside the coalition. The Lib Dem business secretary Vince Cable has continued the fight, arguing that a cap could harm business. But a compromise has now been reached, perhaps at the upper end of what the Tories were hoping for. It's thought that will be somewhere around 43,000. Whatever's been decided, it is safe to say there'll probably come a point when just one place in Britain remains for skilled non-EU workers. So we've had 42,999 and there's one more spot left. How do we make a judgment on who gets that place? Is it the person who fills a skills shortage, who creates most wealth for Britain, or who will do the most social good? We've assembled a two-person immigration panel to cast its eye over those vying for that final place. We're joined by Lindsay German, socialist campaigner and organiser of the Coalition of Resistance. Hello.
Hello.
And on the line is Katie Hopkins, businesswoman. Hi, Katie.
Hello.
Okay, so we have six for you, and the first person in the queue is the Bangladeshi chef. Let me give you the details right now.
I've been working as a chef for 15 years now, and I create wonderful mouth-watering dishes. Cooking is my life, and I'd love to win a Michelin star one day. I've heard there's a strong demand for curry chefs in your country, and I've also been told that only Bangladeshi cooks can make curry the way the British like it.
So you'll only be able to decide which of the one gets in when we've heard all six, but let's just look at the claims of the Bangladeshi chef first of all. Lindsay German, strong claim to come in?
I think he has a very strong claim to come in. I think that we do need restaurants, we do need people who can cook, and we'd be a much poorer place in this country if we didn't have the Bangladeshi restaurants.
Katie Hopkins?
No, absolutely not. Our restaurants are closing down at, I think there's a record number per week now closing down, so I'm sure that we have surplus in our current economy of chefs and restaurants.
Okay, next up, Filipino care worker.
I'm nearly 50 years old now, and in the Philippines, all the jobs go to younger nurses. My friend works in Swansea in a care home, and she said the British do not want to look after the old people themselves, so there are plenty of senior positions. I have two children to support, so it's perfect for me.
Is this a skilled job, Katie?
Skilled job. I think care workers are massively under-supported in our society. However, this lady is 50 years old and has two children, and I think we have to recognise that our society cannot continue to support people with universal access to healthcare and education. So this is a no for me.
Lindsay German, no or yes?
I think she should definitely come in. I think we rely on care workers from coming all round the world, and this country would not have an NHS, would not have the caring that we do have if we didn't have people coming from places like the Philippines.
We now have a Chinese bank worker who earns £60,000 a year. He works for a bank with offices in Shanghai and London.
It's a really good opportunity for me to come to the UK. It will really progress my career with the bank. If you want to get to a senior position, you have to spend time outside of China. The bank will pay all my rent and pay for flights home on top of the £60,000 salary, so it's a really good deal for me.
And Lindsay, you love bankers, don't you?
I'm not very fond of them. I can only think that the Irish will certainly be thinking today that they wish they hadn't let as many bankers into their country. I don't think that these people are contributing much to the economy. My real view is anybody should be able to come to this country, but I think if you're talking about usefulness in society, then these are very, very low down the pecking
order. So you're saying no to the Chinese banker, are you?
I wouldn't say no to any immigrants coming into this country, but they would not be my priority.
Katie?
I think bankers generate wealth for our society, and that wealth does trickle down.
Well, where have you been, Katie, the last 3 years?
Yes, indeed, with the media perception of bankers.
And well, also, we've just paid $7 billion from George Osborne is giving to the Irish bankers.
Well, I think we have to support all countries, don't we, if we take your line. And I think intercompany transfers in excess of $40,000 are actually allowed within this permit. So she would be allowed to come in, yes?
Yeah, well, that's true. But for the sake of the argument here, we are. But you would still let this Chinese banker in.
She's on my list.
Okie dokie, next one.
I've been working in IT for around 8 years. I'm in charge of a team of staff developing apps for smartphones. People tell us what features they'd like to see, and we try to make it happen. I want to try living abroad for a while, and London is one of the best places for my type of work, so that's where I want to go.
Now, this lady is an Indian IT worker, and the significance there, Katie, is that there are an awful lot of Indian IT workers.
There are. Most of them, though, are placed within their own country, and we outsource or offshore to these people. The app market is massive right now, so massive potential here for wealth creation, massive potential here for job creation, so definitely on my list.
Lindsay, on yours?
I've got no objection to this lady coming to Britain, but I don't think apps on mobile phones are the most important things we should be worrying about.
But at some point, Lindsay, you've let almost everybody in now. Do you not start...
This is because I don't agree with the cap.
I just wondered at what point you start campaigning for British people to get some of these jobs.
Well, the thing is, Jeremy, as has already been said by Katie, anybody earning over 40,000 can come in anyway. Any Premier League footballer can come in anyway. What about the people who do the really useful jobs in society? What about letting them in as well?
The 40,000 only counts if you are being transferred within a firm, firstly. And we're going to have a footballer in a second. For the sake of this, they're all in the queue. There's one spot left, and now we have the American. He's a nuclear physicist. Here we go.
They're doing some really great work at Oxford University, and it's right in my field of speciality at Harvard. Those guys have access to the Hadron Collider in Europe, and some of the experiments they're doing are pretty cool. Plus, my girlfriend's British.
That's my colleague Tim Collins doing his American accent, by the way. Katie, would you let him in?
That's a shocking accent. And the Hadron Collider drives me absolutely mad. I'm not big on nuclear physicists, would never be attracted to one. However, that shouldn't be a criteria for assessment. And clearly, it's possible he has skills that we don't have in this country. So, again, he's on my short list of three.
I didn't realise you were viewing their attractiveness as a part of this, Katie.
I think it's important to take a very wide-ranging view.
Lindsay?
Well, I think I'm against nuclear power and I'm against nuclear weapons, so he wouldn't be top of my list.
He might have skills in diffusing them.
I would rather his skills were used in terms of doing something which was more profitable to humanity. But again, I really feel that in a society which is made up of very, very many different components, and where you find that immigration is very much connected to economic growth and actually goes down when there is economic recession, as there is at the moment, then really we shouldn't really be talking about excluding anybody from this.
Lindsay, so you just let everybody in?
Welcome all. Come
and use our universal access to health.
Yes,
I do actually
take that view. I take the view that if you look historically at immigrants, they have put far more into this country than they have taken out.
I would create jobs
for people, and I do think that we rely on people with skills coming from right across the world to do jobs that either we're not skilled enough to do or that people in this country no longer want to
do.
We should be very grateful that they come and do these jobs.
Our unemployed people are drawing on benefits whilst they sit here and watch other people come in and take jobs.
This whole cap is actually a sop to the anti-immigration arguments in this country, because as Nick Clegg said, and I don't agree with very much he said, most immigrants come from the European Union anyway.
100%.
They are allowed into this country anyway. So this attempt to have a cap at 43,000 is just a way of forcing people to make decisions which are impossible decisions.
These are not people cleaning loos. These are skilled workers from outside the EU. So Britain does have discretion. It can say yes or no. And we've got one more for you. And this is a footballer from the Ivory Coast who wants to play for Chelsea.
From when I was a little boy, I dreamt of playing football in Europe, just like Didier Drogba. His picture is everywhere on Ivory Coast. I am fortunate Chelsea have given me a contract. The Premier League is one of the best in the world because clubs buy up all the international talent.
Katie, I'm thinking you're a definite yes here.
I am a definite yes. I love the Ivory Coast. I love boys that come from the Ivory Coast. I think going for Chelsea is a good thing for my partner, sports Man U. And importantly, it's not a skill we can recruit in the UK. It's not a skill we can grow in the UK, because this level of excellence is not something you can nurture. It is something that is innate. So I say yes to the footballer.
You've got 43,000 people watching Chelsea every week, and if the Ivory Coast player wasn't there and no other foreign players were there, they would have to put some British or English players on in front of those crowds, and presumably they'd be better players as a result, wouldn't they?
No, from a purely business perspective, the football market is absolutely massive from a spectator point of view, from a transaction point of view, from a general interest point of view for the general public. So I say it's important to make maintain a massively high standard in that market, and sticking a British player in there or other British players is not going to create the football market that we currently have.
Lindsay, do you let the kid from the Ivory Coast in?
I have.
Well, why not? Everyone else has come. Why not?
I was about to say that I would let him
in.
Katie, if you'd let me finish, and I'm not basing it on you, as you seem to be, on
market.
No, you seem to be basing it on personal preferences and on the market. I do believe that any society has to exist by the collective work that people do, and I don't see why we should prioritise people who earn a lot of money for big business rather than people who care for the rest of us.
Wealth trickles down, and people
well,
that
it isn't trickling down, though, is it? It isn't trickling down. It isn't trickling down. The rich are getting richer and the poor are getting poorer. Okay. And you want to cut their benefits even further.
There aren't apparently many, many jobs here that could be done by unemployed people who are unskilled. So maybe this takes us into a different category. But anyway, let me just go through the six then. It's the Bangladeshi chef, the Filipino care worker, the Chinese bank worker, the Indian IT worker, the American nuclear physicist, and the footballer from the Ivory Coast. The Bangladeshi chef, Katie, you said, basically, Lindsay, you said yes to all of them except the banker.
That's right.
Katie, you said no to the Bangladeshi chef and the Filipino care worker and yes to the rest.
Well, they were on my shortlist.
Okay, so we have the six and they're all waiting and there's only one place. And Katie, let me go to you first. Who do you take in?
I'm going to go with, it's a very tough one between the app creator, because they probably are on the forefront of what they're doing, and the footballer. And with consideration, I'm going for the footballer.
The footballer. Lindsay, what about you?
I'm going to go for the care worker. I think that these are people who are undervalued.
50 years old.
Who are, well, does that matter? Are we saying
we're
people
going to have
over 50?
Her in her old age.
Are we saying that people over 50 years old shouldn't have a job?
No, we're saying we shouldn't allow them into our country.
Well, I don't know who you think is going to look after you when you're 50 years old or older than that, because you will rely
on immigrants.
Darling children.
Well, you hope so, but maybe they won't.
Well, they'll be written out the will if they don't.
Well, I don't. That's perhaps a typical attitude, but it's
right.
Not a particularly fruitful
attitude.
One. Yes, well.
Okay, we're going to have you two on again on almost any subject. Thank you very much indeed. So it's the footballer for Katie. Was it the footballer or the apps? I've forgotten.
No, the
app.
Footballer every
the footballer.
Time. Ivory
okay.
Coast, yes.
And for Lindsay, it is the care worker, the Filipino care worker.
That's right.
We're asking who you let in if there's just one place left. Thank you very much indeed to Lindsay German, socialist campaigner, and Katie Hopkins, businesswoman.